Morning, Dove.
Morning, Harris. Look, do you mind not eating over the crime scene?
Sorry, I've been up since 3.
Yeah. What's the situation?
Rosey McGee, 22 years old, been dead for about 3 days.
Who found her?
A friend, her over there.
Peter, we should bring her in.
Yes, we are.
How did she die?
Well, there's no obvious marks on the body, no sign of any struggle.
Looks like she choked to death.
How can you tell?
Well, her mouth being left wide open and her neck being a blue colour would normally indicate strangulation. All the air supply to her lungs was blocked.
Is there a gag or something?
We ain't found much yet, Gov.
Well, get on with it then, Harris. Take Matt Hashcroft and Saxton with you.
Yes, Gov.
And Harris? Results this time, eh? What do you think?
Well, clearly murder, but was it premeditated?
Well, it's clearly not robbery gone wrong.
We'll know more when the forensics get here.
Yeah, we need to get a picture of this girl, find out where she works, her friends, kind of stuff.
We can start with Stacy out there.
Yeah, we need to get her in.
Mom, the Chief Constable's here.
What the bloody hell's he doing here? Harris didn't request an SIO, did he?
Not as far as I'm aware.
Okay, who's the victim?
A prostitute, you think?
She got a name, man?
A one Rose McGee.
Rose McGee, eh?
Look, I hope you don't mind me asking, but what are you doing here exactly?
Well, Ross, a bit of PR on these sort of cases never goes amiss. Head of the constabulary mucking in with the troops and all that.
So, okay, very good.
Yes, Tennant?
We've got a group, Harris and...
Speak up, man!
Harris and a small group are looking for evidence, and me and Alex are going to interview a friend of the state.
Okay. Well, make sure we clear this up nice and quickly, eh? Nice and tidy.
Yes, sir.
And, Tennant, and you, Ross, make sure you let me know if there's any further developments, won't you, as soon as they happen.
Yes, sir.
Good.
Mom!
What, Harris? Mobile!
Yes, Gov. Hello, sir. Ooh. Love to see you on this beautifully early morning.
Phone, Harris.
Well, we've had several phone calls, all made. They've only asked about 10 seconds each.
10 seconds? You think she's calling for help?
I don't know. Were the calls made, Harris?
Last Tuesday, between 8 and 9 p.m.
Last Tuesday? Maybe she was trying to ring someone but couldn't confront them.
Well, bag it up, trace the number, and bring it back to me as soon as you can, Harris.
Yes, actually, Inspector. I think you can report to me first, thank you. I'm going to spearhead this one.
Sir, can we talk about this, please?
I'd love to, Alex, but unfortunately I don't have the time. I've got a meeting, unfortunately. Now listen, I know you're a capable officer, so I'll let you run with this one, but remember I'm the boss, won't you?
Yes, sir.
Why don't you watch where you're going, man, OK?
Sorry, Gov.
And Harris, can you get on tracing that number, please?
Yes, Gov. Right.
Sorry about that, Archers.
That's okay.
Well, it wouldn't have been alright if you'd dropped that. That's a beauty.
Yeah, it is. Thank you.
Well, look, anyway, I've got to get on, alright? I'll see you around.
Alright, catch you around.
Interview with Stacy Richardson commences 1100 hours. Present, Chief Superintendent Ross and DCI Tennant.
I know this is hard, Stacy, this situation.
Give me a break, Tennant. You seem worse than this round our parts.
Look, I don't know what you want to know. I went round as usual, drop off the monthly rota. We had a cuppa and a chat, you know how it is. But this time it was different. She was dead, and it's not exactly how I wanted to start my morning. You know what I'm saying?
I can understand you're shocked by this morning's events, but you have to tell us everything so we can find the killer and bring him to justice.
Tell me, Stacey, did Rosie have a boyfriend? Don't look at him, look at me.
Oh, well, I don't know, the girl was a bit messed up in the head. She couldn't handle her credit card, let alone her boyfriend.
What do you mean she was messed up in the head?
I can't really say.
I promised. There's not a lot she can do now, Stacey. The best you can do for yourself and for her is to tell us everything you know so we can find the killer.
Look, all the girls on the street are worried and they're afraid that they're going to be next. I shouldn't even really be talking to you.
Why couldn't Rosie handle relationships then? Was it insecurity, bad experiences?
Well, there was this one guy. I'm glad she got rid of him. He's a bit of a nut.
A nut?
For all the purposes of the tape, I'm showing Stacy Richardson Exhibit A, one mobile. We found a number on Rosie's received calls list. I just wondered if you know anything about it.
Do you recognise the number, Stacy?
No, I don't recognise it.
Stacy, this is a traceable number and I'll have you for obstruction if you don't tell the truth.
Think, Stacy, come on.
All right. It was this old fella, a priest. I think his name was O'Grady. I promised Rosie I would never say anything.
I thought you named him O'Grady.
Never mind looking at him for sympathy. What else do you know?
Well, his name was O'Grady. He was a priest. And he abused her when she was younger.